The new M1 Macs are solid little machines, but which one should you get? The iMac, the MacBook Pro, or the Mac Mini? In this video, we'll go over the pros and cons for each to help you better decide which is best for you. I'm Rafael and welcome to the channel where our goal is to always fix it in camera and then finesse it in post. And I always appreciate the early thumbs up because there are benefits and downsides to all these new M1 machines when considering it for work, especially photo or video editing, or just everyday computer needs. Internally, the iMac, Mac Mini, and MacBook Pro are essentially the same computer. It really comes down to the form factor, but there are some pretty big considerations choosing the one that best suits your needs. The first questions I would ask is, do you need portability or will you have a dedicated workstation to do your work? How often do you need to take the computer away from where it is right now? Do you already have a keyboard and mouse? Do you have an external display? These questions become very important to helping you decide which model will be the very best use of your money. If you need portability, then the MacBook Pro is the choice 100%, definitely over the MacBook Air. This is where you literally bounce room from room, office to home, coffee shop, or on set, and you need a computer that will go with you wherever you are, and it's always with you. It's a full computer in a very small package. That sounds great, right? It's an easy choice. Well, let's think about that for one second. One of the MacBook's biggest strengths is also its downsize. The size of the screen is actually pretty small, and when doing photo or video editing, it can become an eye strain when using it for too long. The workspaces become very cluttered and can take up the majority of the screen, leaving little room for the actual work view. Another drawback is the lack of ports on the MacBook. You will more than likely need to purchase some kind of USB hub to go along with it. And you can use an external display to have a dedicated workstation at home where you can plug in your MacBook and use a dual screen setup and with a built-in battery backup. But if you need to buy a display, that adds another cost on top of your investment already. The MacBook Pro base model is $1,300 before upgrading any of the SSD or the RAM, and by adding a USB hub and potentially a keyboard and mouse. Now, if your computer hasn't moved from its location in months, and you will have a dedicated workspace either at home or the office, you have the iMac and the Mac Mini as a solid choice. The iMac is an all-in-one computer, screen, speakers, webcam, and it comes with a keyboard and mouse. It has more ports and a dedicated Ethernet port, so no extra USB hubs really are needed. And with the starting price also at $1,300, it's a great choice. But even though it has a larger 24-inch display, it still may feel too small for a comfortable desktop in the long run. The Mac Mini base model starts at $700, which is almost half the price for both the iMac and the MacBook Pro, but still remains just as powerful. But this is a case where you need to get the keyboard, mouse, webcam, and the display. But if you have any of those, you're in for a huge savings. But even if you needed to buy a keyboard, mouse, and external monitor, and you can find some pretty nice 4K 32-inch displays that will make the photo and video editing experience much better for you. The price of the Mac Mini with a monitor will be nearly the same as a MacBook Pro or the iMac. But the biggest drawback to the iMac and the Mac Mini compared to the MacBook Pro, it doesn't have a built-in battery as a backup, so if the power goes out, the machine goes down. Because these M1 machines are virtually the same computer, and if you have a little extra money and you want the benefit both from the portability and a larger monitor, get the MacBook Pro with an external monitor. It's the best of both worlds. But the costs do start to creep up really fast if you're not careful. If you're trying to decide whether the 8GB versus the 16GB RAM M1 Max are for you, this video may help you choose the right one. Also, I do live streams on my second channel, so make sure you check that out. As always, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.